Get in the Halloween spirit by making your own drinkable potion with all the spooky vibes. What's the key to those spooky vibes? You can probably guess, dry ice. But what actually is dry ice? It's made up of a substance you've also probably heard before, carbon dioxide. But normally we see carbon dioxide as a gas and not as a solid. And that's because carbon dioxide has to be brought to negative 78 degrees Celsius in order to become a solid. Given that there's almost 100 degrees Celsius difference between the temperature of the dry ice and the temperature of our everyday environment, we'll see dry ice behave really uniquely with different substances, and that's something we want to explore with. At its most basic, we'll see that dry ice interacts with room temperature air by quickly changing state, which is something that we'd see with ice made up of water, but it's not melting. We don't see it change state to a liquid. Instead, we see it sublimate, meaning it skips the liquid phase and directly becomes a gas. We can see this as we break the dry ice, exposing it to more and more air temperature, or we can even place a piece of dry ice inside a balloon and see the balloon inflate due to the sublimation. We see the piece of dry ice get smaller and smaller, and the balloon get bigger because that solid is becoming a gas right inside the balloon. We can even speed up the rate of sublimation by putting some hot water around the balloon or placing the balloon in a bowl of hot water. On the flip side, if we place a substance directly on the dry ice, we can see it freeze within moments. Okay, but smoke and freezing aren't really what we're going for in our potion. So how do we get that beautiful eerie fog effect? We have to add another substance, water, and we have to add a good amount. A small drop will just freeze on the ice. If we add a little bit more, we start to see the fog, and then if we really change the ratios and add dry ice into a bunch of water, especially if it's hot, we see lots of fog. Now, even if you've done this before, try to take a closer look at it. Why is the fog moving and behaving in that way, and why does it have that specific appearance? And further, if we actually look at the dry ice in the water and really slow it down, what do you notice about the bubbles and the way that the dry ice behaves? There's so much more going on here than what first meets our eye. That fog is actually a combination of carbon dioxide and water vapor, and we can kind of see that as we slow this down. The white color is from the carbon dioxide gas, and the reason it moves down is because it's denser than air. So we need both the dry ice and the water to have the fog occur, and most liquids are going to have a good amount of water, especially the ones that you're probably putting in the potion. However, if we try this out with other substances like oil, corn syrup, and dish soap, the dry ice behaves in totally different ways, and you can learn more about that in our other video here. All right, on to the potions. Now, this video is a bit different from our others because we're not really sharing a recipe. We started coming up with one and then realized that drinks are so personal and customizable, and that's kind of the beauty of them. You can literally tinker and add a flavor within seconds. So we're gonna leave that up to you. We'll give some suggestions, but this is really all about the drama and effect of the dry ice. Because the dry ice doesn't actually change the flavor or really anything about the drink besides giving it that fun fog effect and cooling it down a bit. So we decided just to experiment and explore with the dry ice, and now we'll go through the potion, but that's where you can really tinker with it too. We suggest taking about 5 different liquids. We went for the seasonal route in terms of flavor and colors, so we got some seltzer, apple cider, ginger ale, green apple juice, and pomegranate juice. These are just the base of your potions, so you probably are going to be combining them in a variety of ways, so we recommend thinking about keeping them fairly versatile and thinking about how they might complement each other. When making your own potion, you can pour the liquid in, and you'll notice that you can actually pour in the gas too. For safety measures, make sure that no solid dry ice gets into your potion. If it does, it needs to completely sublimate before drinking it because it's unsafe to consume. We also recommend that you just blow away the fog before actually drinking it, just to be on the safe side. We hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to like and subscribe for more.